All right, so this part, I'm gonna record it, and I'll post a link to it on Canvas in a couple days, probably. It's a demo on doing the parking lot lab, and I'm gonna do this whole lab in Function Block. Well, I'm gonna do most of this lab in Function Block. I'm going to do a little bit of it in Ladder Logic. So this is kind of like my introductory screen, my main control. What I'm saying here is that if I don't have the e-stop hot, as in its normal position, normally hot, then I'm going to jump to a subroutine called parking lot. But if I hit the e-stop, I'm gonna lose this signal, so the parking lot subroutine won't work anymore, and it's going to send me to this emergency event task. So notice this is a jump to subroutine. This is an event trigger. So there are two different things going on. This is the only ladder logic that I'm going to use in this project. First thing I need with my parking lot, what's the main reason of my parking lot? What am I trying to do?
Get a car in
and a car out. So I need two inputs for that. And one I'll use my green button 0, and the other I'll use my green button 1. And I need to count how many cars are going in, right? So I'll go to timers and counters. I'm gonna use my count up down. Now this guy is really cool because it's a counter that does two things. It can count up and it can count down. All I need to do is my car's coming in, I'll hook that to my count up enable, and car's leaving, I'll hook that guy to my count down. So one counter's gonna go up and down. I need a preset of 6, right? So if I double click on this guy under pre and put that as 6, and then for my done bit, I probably want to turn a light on when it's finished. So I'll just put an output. And I'll hook that to my green light 3. So I've got two inputs. I've got a counter that's going to count up and down. And when it's reached 6, it's going to turn on that light. Let me go online and see if it works. All right, everything's happy. Notice how I've got green all around here. That tells me that I'm online and I'm in run mode. So, you can see when I push this green button 0, watch this little 0, it goes from 0 to 1, meaning it's hot. The other guy goes from 0 to 1. So my two inputs are working, but I've got this light on for some reason. I must have turned that on. Let me go up to 6. Oh, it's not accumulating.
It's the preset 7.
The problem I have is I don't have an e-stop on this panel, so I have to, that's this button, I have to hold it so that it's normally e-stop. So there's my e-stop is not pressed. Now if I go to my parking lot, so I've gone up to set to 8 cars and my green light 3 came on. Okay, what's the next thing I need with this lab?
The button that dispenses the ticket.
Well, that's my sensor, right? No?
You get the separate one. Sensor shows the cars there, and then you press a button, and the green light comes on to show the tickets coming out for 2 seconds.
Okay. So that means
we're using the switches for the sensors, and then we're using our regular push button for.
So I need an AND state. You know what? I'm gonna skip that because I'm gonna run out of buttons on this panel. But I need a timer, right, to lift the arm. So when this first green button goes on, I want to. I want to turn on this timer, but this timer is just like ladder logic, that when you send it a signal, it's going to start, and then as soon as it loses the signal, it's going to stop. So I need to latch it on, and to latch it on, there's a function block called reset dominant, and this is kind of an important one because you're going to use it a lot. So I'm going to add element, RESD. I'll take this input to set, and I'll put the timer enable. What this does is you send a signal to this reset dominant, and it's going to latch on. It's like a seal-in logic. And you're going to use this frequently, because it's the only way to do seal-in logic with function block. So my output, when this goes hot, my output will go hot and it'll turn on this timer. Then what I want to do is I want to reset this guy after my timer finishes. So I can go from this done bit and I can go back around to reset. So that'll reset the timer after it finishes. Now I want to use timer timing on this function block and I don't have it, right? I've got accumulate and done. When I click on the little gray box, it brings up all the options and I can turn on timer timing. Now I've got my timer timing and I'll hook that to a light. I'll go green light, I'll go yellow light 4, how's that sound? Or 3.
Kill the button. Thank you.
Oh, I did button. Now, I've got this reset dominant to seal it in. So as soon as I get a signal, it's going to lock in. It's going to start this timer. When that timer's done, it's going to send a reset back to this guy. This is where you get the kind of catch-22 with function block. It doesn't know where to start. I've got a loop going on here, and if I click on my check, I get errors. It says block is part of an unresolved loop. So all it means is it's not smart enough to figure out where to start. And it's really easy to fix. All you do is either of these two lines, I right click on it and I say assume data available. And notice how it gives me the double arrowhead. Now when I check it, everything's happy. So it's a real small one, but it's really frustrating because if you don't know that little, what that means, unresolved loop, then it's really hard to fix. The only thing I'm missing here is I don't have a preset, and I'm going to put in 2 seconds, so 2000. Everything checks good, I'll go back online. Find out what that is. Okay, I'll hold in my e-stop, push my button. Now, I need to know when I have 6 cars in the parking lot, so I can not let any more cars in. To do that, I'm going to use a compare function. So maybe I'll use a less than or equal to. So if I find compare, there's less than or equal to. I'll tie my my counter accumulator to the less than or equal to, and for source B, I'll put a 6 there. Anytime I've got less than or equal to 6 cars in my parking lot, it's going to give me a hot signal. To give out a ticket, I need a car to arrive and I need a hot signal from here saying that there's space for them. So now I'm going to need an and statement over here so I have both conditions before I can let that signal through. I'll just delete these guys for now. And it's called a Boolean AND, a BAND. So there's my AND. I'm going to hook my green button to it. I'm going to hook this less than or equal to it. And then my output, I go to my counter, and I go to my reset dominant. I'm getting a mess, aren't I? That's why I said one of the problems with function block is you can quickly make a mess of your logic. And maybe I can clean up a little bit. Let's see, if I put this guy down there. That's a little better. Check it. And here I've got unresolved loops again. So I created a loop with all this guy. I need to say assume data available on any one of those lines. It's not much better, is it? That's a little better. So I'll just pick one, assume data available. And that's good. Now, my cars come in, my arm goes up. Notice out of this less than or equal, I've got a hot signal coming out of there. Now I've got 7 cars in, so I'm greater than my capacity. I've lost the hot signal. My parking lot is full and it's not taking in any more cars. So I've stopped it from going, I should have used 5 instead of 6, but I've stopped it from going over capacity. The other thing I need is, I need total daily count, right? So I'm just going to put in another count up down time, count up down. And out of here, I'll just hook that guy. Now I've got my daily count. So I've got my decision to decide if I can let people in the parking lot. I've got my daily counter, or my capacity, so I don't let more in than I can take. I've got my total daily capacity. I've got my timer to turn on a light or lift an arm or whatever it needs to do. And that's most of the lab, right? Could use some cleanup. I didn't give these any particular names. I should have given them better names so I know what. I didn't create any of these tags. Function block's creating them as we go. So I put them in and they're created. Any questions?
And if you change the name, does it change there also in the tag?
Let's try it. So I go to edit tags. My second counter, that's my daily total, right? Mm-hmm. If you go to favorites, got a little text box there. And there. This should answer your question. Okay, I think that's enough for now. There's kind of 3 or 4 very common blocks that you're going to use a lot of. You're going to use this reset dominant. That's to seal in anything that you need to seal in or latch on. There's also one called set dominant. And the only difference is with reset dominant, if you get two hot signals, one saying set, one saying to reset, then it's going to reset. With the set dominant, it's opposite. So they're almost the same thing. You're going to use these. You're going to use these Boolean ANDs. And what do you think the OR one is called?
A BOR.
Boolean OR. B-OR. Count up downs. Timer on reset. Now this timer is not the same one as what's in ladder logic. This is a more advanced timer. It's got more features to it. Same with the counters, not the same one as in ladder logic. So there's a lot of things that we're getting into that have a lot more capabilities than in ladder logic. And remember, when you get the loop, you got to click, doesn't matter which one you pick, pick one of those lines, right click on it, assume data available, and that'll resolve that.